Hi, this time we're going to talk about the camera settings. We're going to use some start settings that will fit for most photo booths. Keep in mind, there is no fixed setting that will work for every situation. You will need to adjust your settings depending on your location and your surrounding light every time. A good flash unit can help a lot in most circumstances. In our case, we're going to use a Canon camera, but you can also use Nikon cameras. A popular photo booth camera for the moment is the Canon M50 Mark II, but use what you have available if it is supported by the software. You can check the supported cameras on the Dslrbooth website. The first thing to do is to set the camera in manual mode. This is the M symbol on your camera. For now, set the autofocus to on. This is usually done on the lens itself. Important: remember that DSLR will control your basic settings from in the software and will overrule your manual settings on your camera. Let's check the settings. In the main page, go to Tools and select the DSLR camera settings. You need your camera to be connected before you will see these camera settings. Make sure you are on the Photo tab. In the top, you see the mode your camera is using, in this case, M from manual mode. Next is shutter speed. See it as how long the light will hit your camera sensor. Important: when using a flash, never go higher than 125 to prevent black bars or half-exposed pictures. This mostly occurs when your flash and shutter are out of sync. When using no flash, you can go higher, let's say to 250, but keep in mind that you're losing light as the time the light hits the sensor is getting shorter in every step. Next is aperture or f-stop. This is basically how much light your lens will get onto the sensor. A low number is more light, but a shallower focus area. Basic lenses will let you set it to maximum 3.5 or 4. Expensive lenses will have a 1.5 or even lower aperture. For photo booths, this is not necessary. Keep your aperture around 8 or 9 to get everybody sharp in your photos. Next, ISO. This is how sensitive your camera is to light. A higher number like 1600 will get you more light, but also increase the noise in your pictures. I recommend not to go higher than 1600, but for mirror booths, you sometimes need to go to 3200 because of the loss of light with the tinted glass. White balance, normally explained in Kelvin, but on cameras sometimes referred with symbols to keep it simple. When using a flash, leave this on flash, 5600 Kelvin. When using cloudy symbol, you will get a little warmer pictures, 6000 Kelvin. Don't use auto white balance as this will give you a slightly different color with every picture the camera makes, as the camera tries to compensate for every color and nuance over and over. So keep your camera at shutter 100, aperture 9, and your ISO 800 to start. Now adjust the power of your flash unit to get a good exposure. Slightly adjust the aperture or ISO if you are on the maximum flash intensity. If your live view is dark and your pictures are fine, make sure the auto-adjust live view function here is enabled. Activate delay capture if you have an old Canon camera. The resolution of your Canon camera for photo booth use is best set on S2. The exact resolution you will get depends on the model you're using. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe.